Man, I think we underestimate how stress shows up. And so when you're stressed out, right, you can't think straight. You are very irritable. Your communication is off. And I'm talking about myself, not necessarily those people that are reading this or listening to this. But I think that if we can recognize that how I do a lot of work around self, right? So personal and professional development. So if I'm stressed out, here's what my typical behaviors and responses are like. If we can identify that within ourselves, I think we can also recognize how that impacts our teams. I don't remember the second part of your question, but before I ask the follow-up, I think most people really don't focus on themselves first, and they think, oh, I just want to, make the team better. But I genuinely believe that in order to work on the team, work on those dynamics, work on any type of communication or even conflict, in order to address that, we have to address what's in ourselves first. And so I think stress is one of those underlying things that just goes, we miss it a lot simply because we're not thinking about how it impacts other people, which ultimately thinks we're not impacting ourselves. So here go the three tangible tips. I say first thing, you should understand yourself. So the first thing is understand who you are, what you like, what you don't like, what stresses you out. What kind of gets, what moves you towards stress? Second thing is you understand others, right? So what are they like? What are they not like? How do they prefer to be communicated to? What stresses them out? What creates stress? What even releases the stress for them? Hey, maybe you need to take a walk. Hey, you buy something or drop off a random gift. And then once you understand self and then understand others, the third thing is now you make the necessary adjustments and adapt. So prime example for me, I'm a better husband, I'm a better coworker, I'm a better manager when I go work out. If I don't work out, oh, it's a whole nother person. I'm a whole nother person. I'm also a better person, a better communicator when I've had some type of food or drink in me before I started meeting. So before we jumped on, I said, man, let me go ahead and give me some toast, drink some water, kind of calm myself when I have ample time to, get ready and prepare versus, rushing and feeling like I'm not, organized. Then I'm not stressed out, which then means my interactions with people can become more enjoyable. So, in order to become a better communicator, I recognize I used to think people just don't listen well. And that may be true, right? But ultimately, I had to realize that I don't explain things very well. And so, while because of my style, right, I'm more direct, I'm more faster paced, I think that I'm just giving you something that you can run with. And then I'm communicating to people who need more detail or who want more detail or who are way more linear where I'm more abstract. And so, I had to not only learn how do those other people prefer to be communicated with, I had to also learn for myself. I tend to breeze over things a little bit faster and not go into detail. So let me work on explaining things in detail, explaining things more linear, and also recognize that I can assume that they catch it because I'm a faster processor. They may not be. Everyone's different, right? And so I think one of the first things is to recognize what are some of the characteristics or traits of those personality types inside those teams, right? And so I talk about a few of them in my workshop, but I'll use myself for an example. If I'm a person who has an extreme sense of urgency, what a don't to do for my end is to not rush. And so I have to recognize also because I have a extreme sense of urgency and I'm a direct communicator, that there may be times when I say things and it comes out completely wrong. I've had to work on my tonality basically my whole entire life, right? So it's not, we hear it all the time. It's not what you say, it's how you say it, right? And so if you're a person who's not as expressive or not as engaging, you don't want to kind of bust their bubble and say, hey, bring it down a notch, right? Because you're asking them to be or to do something that's very unnatural to them. But if you are a person who is maybe more reserved, you might say, hey, I might need more time to process. Or, if you tend to ask a lot of questions because you're very analytical or very process oriented. Maybe instead of asking 12 questions, you say, hey, I got 5 questions, right? And so I think all of it is typically about how do you set up the engagement or the conversation or the interaction, and not necessarily tell people what you need, even though that's important, but you teach people how to treat you. So if you prefer to do things a certain way, it might be okay to say, hey, typically, this is how I prefer to do things. How do you prefer to do things? So we can find our way to meet in the middle. You want to get better. I know something about you that you never even told me. I know you want to get better. I know you want to improve in a certain area. Maybe you don't have that area identified, but if you're going to come to this conference, you're going to get better. There's some nugget, there's some characteristic or trait, there's some piece of information that you're going to get that's going to help you get to the next place or the next level. So that was the first thing. The second thing I would say is do what everybody else is not doing. And when you hear that, you might think, okay, well, everybody's going to a conference. Well, not everybody, right? I think most people are actually very content and settled with where they are. And so my challenge to you is do what other people are not doing. Maybe people are going to conferences, but they're not following up and being engaged in the chat for a Q&A. Maybe they're not looking through the attendee list and actually reaching out to people on LinkedIn or whatever social platforms are available to make other connections. Maybe people aren't really taking the information to heart. They're just kind of sitting through because your job's going to pay for it. I don't know. But I would say do what everybody else is not doing. And then the third thing I would say is because you are not like everybody else, because you want to get better, I would say taking every opportunity as an opportunity that leads to another opportunity. You don't know what you're going to hear, what you're going to experience, who you're going to meet, who you're going to get connected to, how you're going to be inspired. But I genuinely believe that today and the day that the conference airs and all of those opportunities that we get leads us to the next opportunity. Yeah, and then I would say for attending my workshop, I can promise you this is not going to be like any other workshop that you've ever attended. But I do think that I pride myself on creating experiences and conversations that can be relatable, that can be relevant, and also can get you to the place that you say you want to get to. So there's a nugget, there's something in the workshop that you need to have so that you can go to the next level, so you can become a better communicator, a better leader, and ultimately a better human being. Yeah. I would like to invite you to pause. First P is pause. So as a project manager, you have things to do. You have things to do that you don't even write down, but you know in the back of your mind, I got to get this thing done. And when you pause, you can disrupt the flow of things. You get an opportunity to breathe, to just take a step back, to recalibrate, or to just turn your mind off. And because I know how project managers work, you're always thinking, you're always moving, you're always growing, right? And so I would say pause first. Then let's think about the possibility. So maybe you're working on a complex problem. Maybe you're trying to solve something inside the organization or for a project. And let's think about the possibilities, right? What could be? Yes, there may be a bunch of rules and regulations and red tape that are associated, but having the opportunity to think about possibilities really gets your mind going and can free you up from the mundane tasks that we typically are exposed to. And then the last P would be participate. So this can go two ways. I would ask you to invite someone to participate with you. So maybe there's something that you're working on. Maybe there's a project that is exciting and that you are excited about, but there's someone else that probably could benefit from your learning, from your leadership, and from your engagement. The other thing is, what can you participate in with someone else? Right. So often as project managers, I think we are locked in. We got to get this thing done and we're laser focused on that thing, which is great. But we're missing out because we're so isolated and we're not connected. And I just genuinely believe community can happen in any place as long as you are invited to participate or you invite other people to participate with you. So I would say pause, think about possibilities and participation.